sometimes dreidels in the sky. Let's see. One sec. Just have to get this set up. There, all good. I just have to make sure some stuff is actually working. Yep, it's working. We're good. Okay, that's better.
Sorry, I had to get something out of my throat. No, I need the... to go grind out some CP. There we go. That's 6 friends, the last one. Sorry, zone out for a second. I'm doing something in the background. Zoe's probably, Chloe's probably gonna go down. No?
I'm so sorry.
And she's down. Saw that coming. Could have healed her, but. Excuse me. Yeah. Use. Preemptive attack, good. Let's get all the bugs fast. We have to reduce damage by as much as possible. It should only be like one, but one's better than none. Alright, there we go. There we go. Sorry about that. Don't just really. I want to be able to do anything in peace to nowadays. No, I'm not allowed to. I literally just got up to let the one in, and now you ask me to get up to let you in. Couldn't you all just come in at once? No, because it can't be that easy. You have to make it hard as physically possible and demanding on me. Because it's like, I can't leave the door open. Sorry, running out of time. I can't leave the door open because of the puppies, so they'll come in here and literally jump around everywhere else. So no, I can't leave the door open. Because we'll hit the keyboard, we'll hit the mouse, they'll pop the wall, disconnect the computer, which we have done. But I'm not contending with that right now. Bigger dog's fine, I can let them in. So I must be doing something in the background.
You're not coming in.
That is not Duke, that is Fred whining at the door. No, Fred, no! Go, Fred. Fred? Sorry about that, related business.
You came up short.
Filling salts. Oh no, it's a mimic. Battle. Wait, no, false alarm. Honestly, that would be great. Mimic monster in this game. Alright, let's go up. You're not coming in! Fred, no! Sorry if you can hear that. I can't have him in here. But he really wants in. He's being really stubborn about it. I'll be right back. Back. Sorry about that. Gotta kind of get properly set up again. Something to probably set up again, which I am now set up. No, they don't have integrate. You have to run from that battle. Outside of that battle, though. Basically got everyone to max CP, except close to max CP. A little more and I would have had them all at max CP. But I don't want to risk it, and I don't want to use my items. So... secretly in the wrong door. All right. There we go. Test. Test. Alright, there we go. There we go.
Savor the victory. We earned it.
Preempt, please. Good. There we go. I'll use one healing item. Ha!
messed with the wrong guy.
And I looked away for a second while clicking. I literally told him no. He's not allowed in. Went out there, played with him for a moment, and now he's just clawing at the door constantly. I can't win! Thank you.
we're good to go!
I didn't realize I was muted. Sorry. I don't know how long I've been muted. I'm an idiot. But, good thing I was muted, because I've been slightly raging at Doggo, because they won't stop. His name is Fred. He's a puppy. He doesn't know when to stop. Move. No, it's gonna absorb nutrients and regain most of its health. No? Huh. Absorb nutrition. No.
Done already?
Beat it! Finally! Stubborn!
We gotta talk now that we can let the capital's just a hut.
Boy, so there's nothing to worry about. That's not good.
Huh.
There we go.
They messed with the wrong guy.
There we go.
No crit for you. No attack for you.
No. Of course you get a critical. Take my critical, why don't you? Ugh. Because of course you go for Chloe. Because you have no better person to go for than the healer. Now Stella's gonna go down, even though I grinded up all the CP, it's all gonna go down the drain, because the game's just like, oh, yeah, okay. Yep, there goes all my CP. I'm gonna Stella and Chloe. This fog is so annoying.
No, there's a lot of these, okay. Very warm. Okay.
The chest is empty as you suspect it would be. Inside the chest is emptiness. That's all there ever is. Eternal and intermittable. Chest and you're human, our love can never be. Let it go. You pee judge. The chest is empty. You came to disappointment with sound off its wooden walls. Melda talent? Small spider, skid us from one side of it. Empty chest to the other. It acts kinda cute. What the heck did I just get? Emerald Talisman. This thing's not powerful, it's just annoying because it drains CP. Drains some CP. Wait, no, not these. Was it? Yeah. Can't remember. Did they just drink CP? My memory's not working, bro. Okay, that shouldn't account for the surprise attack and the pump for the DOE.
Well, that takes care of that.
takes so much.
They messed with the wrong guy.
All right.
Savor the victory. We earned it.
I barely talk. I don't have much to talk about.
Well, that takes care of that.
Up to the top of the tower, 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 we go, 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 go.
Thank you.
Ugh. Of course, it's gonna go for a while.
They messed with the wrong guy.
There we go. This just looks sad and deflated now that you've taken all its stuff. Alright, there we go. There we go. I went the wrong way, diamond staff. Ooh, I don't care, I went the wrong way. Good. As you open the box again, you think about what it would be like if you lived inside of like a little house. Be cramped, but quaint. Thank you. I just want to get out of here. I just want to get to the top. Shields for ooh, you find the greatest treasure of all, friendship. Duende's slippers. You might look at this chest and think it's empty, but that's just negative thinking. Not to see this baby and marvel at this amazing air inside. Oh yeah, no, I'm not dropping that.
Savor the victory. We are.
Active. Quick. Destroy it. That was the least confusing to navigate. All right, there we go.
shake.
Come on, to the mine. The fog is cleared. So along the Milk Trail, the fog goes all the way to 140 cells just from the city. Not only does the fog extend halfway up the last mountain, but there are monsters everywhere. This is bad. Yeah, I don't ever remember it being this bad. Anyway, I've checked all three roads, so I'm not back in a Podine, alright? Unless you can think of any other crossing, but I said that's right. I'm not looking for those right now. They're long term quests. I should be able to do them for a bit. Did you guys hear the sound of the bell just now?
I did, it sounds quite distant, however.
Real pretty sound, too. Yeah, I know. I was like, looking at the thing for a second there. Shay, are you okay? You're spacing out. Oh no, it's nothing. Like you said, it's a lovely sound. It enchanted me for a moment, that's all. You too, huh? You don't hear a bell that nice often. I wonder if we even got one in or something. It's possible. Anyway, we have a clear picture of how far the fog sends out. We should let Ina know. Yeah, let's get back. Good work, everyone. Let me pay you for your effort before we continue. I have to admit, though, I was expecting a more vague report. The fog has boundaries that clearly defined. Yes, it's all but impossible to think of it as an answer when you see it. It's a little unclear on just how the entire fog cloud is. Let's take a look at it on the map. So, if it's 60 cells down the Lee's Highway, 80 cells down the main road, and 140 down the Mulga Trail, it should look something like this. That's not really as helpful as I thought it'd be. Yeah. Yes, it's strange. The way fog spreads should change based on its point of origin, direction of the wind. Meaning we're still completely in the dark on what's causing this or what it means. All we can do is stay ready for anything. Right, so the army's still on the fence about mobilizing too. Oh, that reminds me. Hey, Tita. I don't know if Grandpa has any inventions that are like a fog remover or something. You know what? Grandpa did make something called a dehumidifier once. So it removes water vapor from the air, right? So it could be used. I don't think so. It's meant to be used indoors. You need hundreds to affect a place as big as Roland. Even if we had them all, it wouldn't fix the actual problem. Technology fails us, huh? It'd be nice if we had some solid evidence societies behind this. Feels like a half cooked, I think. For them, anyway. I think you mean half baked. And, what makes you say that? So, for everything they've used their gospel for has been sort of world shaking phenomenon, right? Literally, in one case. But just producing some fog isn't really that impressive. Good point. I think this would be the, like, a flesh eating doom fog thing or something coming from them. And let us not forget. Every time they have given us a message in some form or another, this time however, not a mama. Wait, have they? Morello's ghostly projections, the wolf appearing amongst sheep and our kitten's lovely letters. Each time they were provoking signs, firing us into action, but yeah, silence. True, I guess. Put it like that, it does come across as rather half baked. Shit. Is something the matter? A message? You may have received one already. What? What? When did we? Help! Someone! Miklos? Still, hello. Miklos, I am. What's wrong? You look like you just ran. Wait, why am I getting the weirdest sense of deja vu? Miklos, please catch your breath. Something happened. Something? You could say that, yes. I'm glad to see you all safe, at least. May I do you? May if you could explain. Just a few moments ago, Lydia collapsed in my home. Several other citizens have faded in the same way. What? I've been to all the houses and it seems the symptoms are the same in every case. Their breathing is stable and their pupils look fine. They seem to be asleep, so they shouldn't sicken father, I think. See, it's a small mossy at least. I couldn't rouse them, have I done? I need to elaborate. Man, we have to find a solution as fast as we can. Be strong yourself. That would be no shame in needing to take a seat. I'm okay. Just even Elise's mom and Luke collapsed. It's kind of a shock. So if you're not feeling well, you can go back to your guild, you know, or at least you could rest at home. No, can't let myself get all mopey, you know. But do you really have no idea why that comes up? I'm afraid I don't. I just wish I did. Traditional chakra remedies for awakening the sleeping eye. Walking, so I don't think it's a poison or illness. It's not more like Adios preserves us, but like their souls are trapped by something. Their souls. At the moment, it seems the best course of action would be to visit the homes of the affected. We need to find out what exactly the situation was like when they sent Oma. Right, let's go. Sure that, as of now, in my capacity, may have fallen, I'm only questing guilt. Please, go cause this and assuage the fears of people. Just see what does me. We'll do anything in our power. Hey guys, am I the only one who suspects society's behind all this? No, I'd say it's likely at this point. Deep sudden coma in the local chat, that can do nothing about it. This suddenly seems like the sort of incredible phenomenon we were talking about. I think that was just when I was being paranoid. I don't have to wonder, has anyone received a message? That's a good question. You did write down the full list of people who fallen comatose, yes. Oh, one second. Lydia, Tabitha, Ashton, Radford. We can begin by asking the family friends for suspicions. We can return to Guild Home and we've done so, right? I just have this feeling. for questioning before it's too late or stuff. Wrong way, anyways. Hey, at least, sorry. Tell, yes, hi, guy. That's okay. When did you come back from Paddy? That's alright. You didn't come back for so long. Haha, I'm sorry. I got kind of busy and couldn't say hi. So, is your mom doing alright? Well, it seems like she's sleeping, okay, but I'm worried she won't, like, wake up or do anything, even if you shake her. But the vines have nothing to worry about, but I see you investigating this at the cusp of the mayor. Could we ask you a few questions? Oh, yes, sure, sure. It's amazing you are. Okay, then, faster, let your mother fall asleep and win. He's about five, I think. Mom and I went out to clean the chairs and stuff on the chairs. Yeah, we figured they might get damaged from all the humidity in the air due to this creepy fog, you know? We finished waterproofing the ground floor, you see, so we figured we totally stored the chairs, too. I see, alright then. Okay, so while we were cleaning up, Dad called me. When I got back, I was all zonked out in one of the chairs, so you didn't see her fall asleep. And yeah, sorry. So I tried talking to her, shaking her, but she wouldn't wake up. I totally forgot and called Dad, and he carried her to the bed, and then she went, Emma, Elisa. Sorry. I'm sorry I'm losing it, because you're home too, still. Yeah, I know. It's okay, you don't need to worry. Yeah. Okay, no thanks. Do you want to ask me one sec? Do you got anything? Possibly. Did anything strange happen before you came? Before you came back to your mother? Before or after your mother went to sleep, did you see anyone you didn't recognize or hear anything strange? People I didn't recognize? Actually, yeah. Just as I was heading inside, I saw this lady coming out the clock tower. A woman? Was it someone from Roland, you think? Well, I couldn't see her face. The fog made it kind of hard to see deals, but her clothes were really weird. I figured she had to be a traveler of some sort, you know? Really weird, what was that about? She was wearing this sort of black dress robe thing. I can't lie, it was kind of hot. It was a bit hard to see details, though. The fog, like I said, I see still. This is real available. We need to go tell Ina this. Yes, absolutely. Thank you, Elise. Helped us tremendously. Oh, no. It's okay. Good luck with your investigation, sir. And don't worry. Okay, you can count on us to save your mom. Let's forget this out and wake her up. I know. Thanks, Michelle. I know the house. The house is somewhere. I just can't remember. That's not the house. It would tell me. It might not tell me. Oh dear me, it's still bright, look at you. You see race and everything. Hey Miss Maggie, pal. Maggie, pat, sorry, didn't say hi, Ellie, pal. We hot about Luke. Let's stay. Oh, well, hey, Pat, is it that bad? Well, you see, a little Pat is the one who found Luke at the glass. Oh no, Pat, don't worry, it'll be okay. Maggie, how's your grandson? Is he yet? No? No, not at all. He's just sound asleep. I think this is all a bit of a fuss. You're saying, well, I'm sure. I'll ask him to show himself out. Like always do, you know? Really, not waking up. Foolish, Maggie. Hey, Pat, can you tell us what happened when Luke fell asleep? That's gonna happen on behalf of the mayor. On behalf of the town. Pat, if he does anything, you can tell us. The mayor has told us. Like, Luke, please, Pat. I'll tell you. Pat, when did you find Luke fell asleep? I wasn't there when he fell asleep, but I found him on top of the clock tower. I think it was just past five. We were playing hide and seek in the fog. I was there and I was looking for Luke, and when I found him, he was asleep. I thought he was just being a jerk and tried to wake him up, but he wouldn't. I see. Wait, one thing I don't see. Who the heck carried Luke down from the clock tower? Oh, that was Miss Paddington. He came up and found us just when I was trying to figure out what to do. He said he came up to make sure the clock was working and the fog wasn't causing any problems. Oh yeah, that's just like Mr. Paddington. Okay, now that I got the gist of a Pat, I was wondering, you were playing daddy, did anything strange happen? Strange? See anyone you didn't recognize, hear anything sounds. Like a cell, anything could help. I don't remember much except all the white fog. I don't remember thinking it was really creepy, not seeing anyone landing. What? I see. Creepy fog aside, nothing really suspicious. Huh, no, it seems that way. Thank you, both of you. You've given us some food for that. We'll get a big help, dearie. Cell, is Luke gonna be okay? Yeah, you bet he will. I don't cry anymore, okay? Luke, a little teeth here. He finds out when he wakes up, you know. Okay. Yeah, I won't cry anymore.
Mill Gate, West Gate. See, considering I need to talk to him. There he is. Oh, hello. Your son's chairs, alright? Yes, yeah, it's good news. We're here to discover what it's made, but Mr. Bradford, okay? Yes, but there's been no change, I'm afraid. He's sound asleep and seems comfortable, but we couldn't wake him up no matter what we do. It's the only option to wait and watch over him until morning. I'm afraid so. That's all you can do for now, at least. I know it's the bedtime, but we ask you a few questions. Of course. I don't know if we can answer everything, but I'll be happy that I can. Thank you, you two. I'll say, when and where did Radford fall asleep? The time? Around 5:30, I guess. The place? Well, just outside the door, essentially. Outside the door? So, what, in the hallway? Yeah, I heard a knock and a voice saying, I home? I knocked the door to greet him, but when I did, I found my father-in-law on the ground unconscious. To be honest, I thought father had simply gotten drunk again, but I couldn't smell the alcohol in his breath. Thought it was strange, and then we couldn't wake him up no matter what we did. So we went to go see Father Divine. See, I think I understand the situation. One last question for me. Was there anything odd about the situation before Red Fox fell asleep? Anything odd? Wait, you mean like the splash of fog aside from that? For example, do you see anyone odd? Any special noises? I don't think of when you were tracking Red Fox in. You notice it too? All the stuff I saw, I just imagined it. What is it? We were putting Bradford to bed. We both heard it seems like sound of a bell. Alright, there we go. The sound of a bell? Hold on a second, didn't we hear one too? Surprisingly lovely, I thought we thought someone rang one. Thank you, you've given us a lot of information. If you don't remember anything else, please contact the guild straight away, alright? Yes, of course. I'll leave it to us then. We'll be back to check up tomorrow. Okay, thank you, Estelle. Alright. I can walk. I'm only doing this once. So she's out walk up her man to make cross tell you about it. She's interested in your fan case. Is there anything I can do to help? Please feel that feel asked. Thank you. Well firstly, how's Lita? Oh, Lita, she won't wake up no matter what we do. I pray she'll never wake up normally come the sunrise. Whatever that's worth in this fog. But for now, all I can do is keep an eye on her. That's awful. Maybe it's like the leader collapsed. Do you remember when? Let me see, it would have been just about 4:05. I stepped out of the kitchen and found a class in the entryway. And a little needless to say, called the class, she was able to carry her to bed. To think there are others affected the same way. She collapsed at the entryway? Hang on, was the door locked at the time? I don't believe it would have been. After all, people have been visiting all day to speak to my husband about how to deal with the fog. Well, that's a list of suspects. It's so long, then.
Well, how long were you in the kitchen, by the way? About 30 minutes, I suppose. Alright, I think I've got a picture of what happened. One last thing, if I may. Is there anything strange before or after the litter collapsed? Strange, what do you mean? Did the house have any unfriendly visitors? Did the house have any unfriendly visitors, or were there any sort of these things to clam? Let me think. Well, I'm not sure I'd call it strange, but it was notable. Well, it was in the kitchen. I had the faint sound of a bell. The sound of a bell here, too. So it sounds. So later rang it, perhaps. But that reminds me, I haven't been able to find the bell. I wonder where she put it. I can't stop thinking about it, man. But if anything happens, please contact the guild once. Yes, of course. Oh, and everyone take care. Yeah, Neil, yeah, thank you for the help. I have to get used to this. So, if wait, what? Who did I miss? That poor showed up now? Why? Know what to do, what to do. Oh, you all here? It's been a while. We saw the job puzzle on the board. Oh, I'm so sorry to call you so late at night. I know it's sudden, but can you find out all for me? Oh, that cat gone again, I take it. How about it? Will you find it for me? Yeah, we should be able to handle the job right now. Given the second I'm done, I wonder if it's the right nose thing. Running to complex situations is an important part of the process. I'm all associated with you can. Wonderful. If you can, could you provide the details? We know that you're looking for a cat. Is that all you mentioned the cat question? Yes, that's right, my little owl ran off. It's fair while I was taking afternoon naps. Oops. This sure seems mightily familiar. That would mean she's been gone past the SEO, you're getting worried. Do you have any idea where she might have gone? If you can think of any spots she might have gone to, that would help. I might have an idea. From what I found out, the landing port seems suspicious. Landing port. Fucked around there and a bit and asked one engineer and they said someone saw a cat. They said it was a light brown kitty, so it must be out. Oh, I should write down the color of the cat, so this is looking, why don't we just see where it takes us, yes. That's good. So that's the landing part. Couldn't agree more. I was glad to help. I'll be waiting here for the war as well. Good luck. We'll help once we found it. Yes, until then, thank you. How long have I been going? Holy cow. About quite a distance in. I can stop here. See you later, everyone. I'll figure out the bell later.